Good viewers, this is mathematics with Dr. Oji. In this video, we shall talk about higher derivatives. Kindly subscribe to my video channel below the video. It is free. And the notification bell so that each time I upload a new video, you'll be daily notified. Thank you. Higher derivatives. If y is a function of x, that is, if y is equal to f of x, the y dx is f prime of x. Differentiating once again gives the square y over the x square is equal to f prime prime of x. This is called the second derivative of y. It is anytime you differentiate y twice, you have the square y over the x squared. Note, d dx of the y dx is equal to the square y over the x squared. In further to this, we can have other higher derivatives such as third, fourth, fifth, till the nth derivative. For example, d dx of the square y over the x squared is equal to d cube y over the x cube. The nth derivative is the nth y over the x raised to the n. Now let's consider the following example. If y is equal to theta raised to the n, where n is a positive integer, show that 1. Theta dy d theta is equal to ny. 2. Theta squared d square y over the theta squared is equal to n into n minus y minus 1 bracket y. Now the solution. Y is equal to theta raised to the n. So if you differentiate the y with respect to the theta, as in our basic differentiation, we're going to have n multiplied by theta raised to the n minus 1. Now, multiplying the y theta by theta, that is, if we multiply the y theta obtained here by theta, we are going to have theta multiplied by the y theta, which is just what? Theta times what we obtain as our y theta is n theta raised by n minus 1. So by the time we multiply theta by n theta raised by n minus 1, we have n theta raised by n. Hence, n theta raised by n is equal to n y, which is what we are asked to obtain as in the first question. Now, we also get the second question. We note that the square y over the theta squared is equal to d the theta of the y the theta, which is n into bracket n minus 1 theta raised to the n minus 2. So that is, this is equal to this. Now, theta squared multiplied by the square y over the theta squared will be theta squared multiplied by what we obtain as the square y over the theta squared is what? N into n minus 1 raised to the, into n minus 1 multiplied by theta raised to the n minus 2. So by the time we multiply this by this, you know, theta squared multiplied by theta raised to the n minus 2 multiplied by n into n minus 1. That is just collect like terms and multiply. So that will give us what? You know, according to the law of indices, theta raised to the 2 multiplied by theta raised to the n minus 2. That would be what? Theta raised to the 2 plus n minus 2. That would be what? Theta raised to the n. Multiply by n into n minus 1. So, and which is equal to what? Because originally in the given problem, y is equal to theta raised to the n. So by the time we now substitute for y here, we're going to have what? Y into n multiplied by n minus 1, that which is the same thing as n into n minus 1 multiplied by y. Hence, the proof is complete. So, that is the end of the proof. Now, don't forget to subscribe to my video channel. It is free. Just click the subscribe button below the video and the notification bell so that each time I upload a video, you'll be daily notified. Thank you.